What do you know about cocaine?
Rush, rush, get the yayo.
Killer.
Buzz, buzz, give me yayo.
I ain't gotta say much, you already hear it.
Rush, rush, get the yayo.
Yo,
go, sell the yayo.
Sell it.
190 carats, killer. Yes, I flipped that white pudding, but I swear I wish I met Dwight Gooden.
Wish
to show him that my pitch is better. Bring strawberry dog, I'll be rich forever.
Shit,
them two niggas copping bricks are better. Hit the cellular, how you want it? Whip the regular. And tell your white girls about my white girl. Shit, I'm part of the reason it's a white world.
I've heard whispers about the financial support your government receives from the drug industry.
Well, the irony of this, of course, is that this money, which is in the billions, is coming from your country. You see, you are the major purchaser of our national product, which is, of course, cocaine.
On one hand, you're saying the United States government is spending millions of dollars to eliminate the flow of drugs onto our streets. At the same time, we are doing business with the very same government that is flooding our streets with cocaine.
See. Let me show you a few of the other characters that are involved in this tragic comedy.
I like coke because I just like really love the way it makes my heart race, and then I can just like fucking party.
I'm on cocaine.
I know that cocaine stimulates your body. What's it called? What do you take when you want to stay up all night at the library?
Adderall.
Adderall. It just felt like Adderall times 10 to me. And like a good friend of mine was into coke, and so like there was a couple nights when I was, I don't know, probably 19, like I was a sophomore or so in college, that I started doing coke. And it was, you know, it was like once I had some, I needed more though to keep it going.
Well, it's very pleasant. The experience is very pleasant.
We are basically chasing these farmers into the heart of the Amazon, scorching the lungs of the earth.
A destruir los cultivos de coca, pero múltiples quejas de la comunidad campesina han mostrado que ellas también han destruido los cultivos de pan coger. También han destruido la seguridad alimentaria. El Guaviare tiene la mitad de sus habitantes en condición de desplazados.
Y por migraciones, porque una de las que ya uno que iba allá con migaron y hay uno que comía allá con migaron yuca.
Sí.
Y ahora mismo que hace uno no hace nada. En el monte que iba a hacer.
More than anything, the places that I would see coke at was like the frat formals.
I'm on cocaine.
Well, if you mooch around at 3 a.m. in the morning, there are some spots in parks where a car pulls up, and students pull up, and they make the exchange.
I don't know, from this, like, frat guy. Like, the guys that I hook up with. And, like, my sorority sisters, and just, like, whoever's around them, like, give it to me, and I can just party with.
Everyone likes to party, I guess.
When we're talking about coca, it's not a difficult plant to grow. And it's not particularly exotic or hard to grow. And it shouldn't cost this much. Not that the farmers are getting wealthy off of this, mind you. The farmers are basically barely able to survive growing coca. It's the middlemen and the cartels that really make the money.
I don't know. Don't they, like, manufacture it, like, somewhere around here? Like, I don't know. There's, like, all those chemicals and stuff.
Whatever guy I was, like, hooking up with, or their roommate, or their dealer, or, I mean, I never had a clue, you know?
Yeah. Where,
Yeah.
Where do you think they got it from?
I don't know. I'm assuming that it came from a larger distributor who had been able to buy it for cheaper.
Yeah.
And probably cut it. And then it was probably not as pure of form and was then sold for a much higher price. Because this is how people distribute shit, especially drugs. But other than, like, Syracuse, I wouldn't have a clue where it came from.
Right now, they're nearing the end stages of making the coca paste, and they told me a list of ingredients that goes into this stuff. There's cement, ammonia, gasoline, sulfuric acid, and potassium permanganate, and baking soda. So, if the drug czar wants to make any prevention messages, commercials, show them how this stuff is made, and you'll never want them to put up your nose again. Right now, the coca extract from the coca leaf is sitting in a gasoline soup, essentially, with these other chemicals. Nobody wants to do this kind of thing. It's not a lot of money, and it's very, very high risk, and there's a lot of violence associated with it.
It just seems like a really expensive habit, and I don't have a ton of money to blow. But it seems like people...
No pun intended.
It seems like people who do have a lot of money do a lot of coke. Like, I meet people, and if they have, like, expensive shoes, like, you know what I mean? Then I'm like, I bet they do coke. Anyone on this campus that has nice things, I have a feeling that they probably had, like, some kind of coke problem and maybe went to rehab. You know what I mean? Like, I know people who went to rehab for coke in high school.
Yeah.
What were they like?
That amazes me. Some of them seem like they have their shit together now, but, like, it is sort of strange when people say they've been to rehab for coke, but now they're doing coke again. I understand, like, addictions are difficult, but I think that it's kind of funny. It's like, you spent all that money to go to rehab, and now you're doing coke again? I know, like, you were, like, what, 17 then, and now you're 21, so you're like, you can handle it, but not really.
You're
such an adult. You're like, oh, now I can manage the coke.
You can't.
Well, coke does something to your system that, it's like the opposite of alcohol, in that, like, you know, like, it's this rush, and there is, like, the fact that it's so expensive, that's, like, there's something to be said about doing expensive drugs. But more than anything, I think people, drink and do coke simply to, like, escape their lives. You know what I mean? I think there's a lot of people in college and people in general that are not exactly happy with themselves. And so, like, you know, the appeal of drugs is, like, huge.
Yeah.
Like, why not try something new and, like, get out of yourself? That's why I did drugs. Funny because, like, in my sorority, my sorority wasn't labeled like a coke sorority. It was more than anything, it was like a little bit more of like a weeds sorority. So that wasn't always something that I would see.
Yeah.
But more than anything, the places that I would see coke at was like the frat formals.
Yeah.
You know, when people get away and they think they're like They're in Canada and like they're in these shitty hotel or motels and they want to like pretend they're in Vegas. they bring tons of coke and then they're like everybody's doing coke all over all the tables and they're like
so rooms,
and it's so funny because you like walk in and like all these girls who like think they're like, you know, they're wearing dresses like they're in Miami or something, but we're actually in Canada and we're in shitty hotels with shitty people and we're doing shitty coke. So it's like, I don't know, it's kind of a bizarre scene. And I was never like really into coke. I would usually be doing coke after I'd done like ecstasy. Because that was like something that I got really into was ecstasy.
Yeah.
And like, no, I don't anymore, but...
What did coke do for you when you do it after ecstasy? What would it do for you? Like, would it just keep you amped up?
I just wanted to keep going. I just didn't want to come down. Because, like, the thought of coming down off of a drug is, it's too much to handle. So you're like, what can I do to keep it going? Like, even if it's this, like, other thing that, like, I would put anything into my system. It didn't even matter if I knew it was definitely what I thought it was.
Yeah.
I just wanted something to keep me up.
I mean, I'm sure it's doing a lot for its economy. If they're importing so much of the drug over here, we're probably paying a lot for it, and it's probably making their economy boom.
I'm on cocaine.
Con la coca, hay mucha dificultad. Y de eso estamos nosotros cansados ya, los campesinos, estamos cansados de la tanta dificultad. Pero más sin embargo seguimos insistiendo porque se vende.
¿Lo van a pillar esto?
Es posible.
Bueno, ya que le he mostrado acá como vive uno, ¿verdad? Que no es como otros piensan que es sacar esto, no sabe.
Pues tiene un proceso.
O que gana mucha plata uno, mentira.
There are those in Washington who say, well, you know, this drug policy may not work, but we have to help Colombia establish stability. And my response to that is, if you try to establish stability, to impose stability, without first establishing legitimacy, we've been there before in the history of U.S.-Latin American relations. It's called repression. That means the state has to do something for these people, not just make demands upon them.
Pero el manejo que las otras personas le dan, no es como nosotros digamos, la planta no tiene la culpa, sino las personas que le dan mal uso a las plantas. Toda planta es, sirve para lo que sirve en la naturaleza, pero si se le da un mal manejo, pues todas las plantas son malas, pero la planta no es, sino el ser humano que le da mal.
It's the 10 crack commandments. Why? Man can't tell me nothing about this coke. Can't tell me nothing about this crack, this weed, my hustling niggas. Niggas on the corner, I ain't forget you niggas. My triple B niggas.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
I've been in this game for years. It made me an animal. It's rules.